Hey there, BrainStuffers. Lauren here. If you like art, permanence, and shallow wounds, you may have a tattoo or seven. And you're not alone. A Harris poll from 2012 indicates that here in the United States, almost 40% of adults under the age of 40 have at least one. So our question for the day is, how do tattoo machines work? And yes, the preferred industry term is tattoo machines, not tattoo guns. As it turns out, the technology used to apply tattoos hasn't changed all that much since the 1890s. Before then, tattoos were given by tapping or just poking needles into the skin by hand. But at the turn of the 20th century, two groundbreaking skinbreaking patents were filed. Each is basically a motorized array of solid needles connected to an ink reservoir. When the needles pierce the skin, the tips pull ink from the reservoir into the skin and deposit it there. This happens because of surface tension and capillary action. You know the way that water will stick a little bit higher up to the sides of a glass than it's level in the middle? The close-set needles of a tattooing device act the same way, pulling the ink down. Some of it gets trapped in the skin and eventually forms the tattoo. But let's look at these two machines, which we should note probably weren't the first of their kind ever used, just the first to be patented. First, we've got New York City tattoo artist Samuel O'Reilly's rotary machine, patented on December 8, 1891. He based the design on an electric pen patented by Thomas Edison in 1876. The pen would punch through paper to create a stencil of your writing, and O'Reilly realized it could just as easily punch through skin to create a tattoo. Thanks for being so unintentionally metal, Edison! O'Reilly's motor is a rotary type, meaning that when electricity is applied, a flywheel spins a cam, which pushes a follower to convert the spinning motion into a reciprocating linear motion of the needles. This lets the needles move up and down very smoothly and rapidly, thus applying the tattoo more easily than most artists could manage via the traditional poking method. However, this machine probably isn't what you think of when you think of tattooing. Imagine the soundscape of a tattoo parlor. In your mind's ear, do you hear a deep, piercing buzz? That's the noise made by a coil tattoo machine, the second design that we're discussing today. The first patent for it was granted on August 23rd, 1904 to Charles Wagner. He was another New York City tattoo artist who based his device on an Edison electric pen, this one driven by electromagnetic coils. The idea is simple. You attach a group of needles perpendicular to an armature bar. That bar is spring-loaded so that it can vibrate up and down. When it's in its up position, it completes a circuit in the machine that sends electricity through dual electromagnetic coils. That creates an electromagnetic field that pulls the bar down, which breaks the circuit and releases the bar back to its up position, starting the cycle over again. Since the tattoo needles are attached to the bar, the vibrations push and pull them up and down. Lots of innovators have built on these concepts, making tattoo machines safer, more precise, and less painful for both the client and the operator. And artists use a few other mechanical designs too. Rotaries and coils are just the most common. Do you have any tattoos? Have you ever applied a tattoo to yourself or others? Tell me your story in the comments. Myself, I don't have any yet, but I've got three different designs in the works. And hey, if you want to learn more about everything from body modifications to eye boogers, head on over to HowStuffWorks.com.